Welcome to our service on the Thursday of Holy Week. Each day during Holy Week, we have a service, and today we will be celebrating communion. If you wish to share in the communion, then you may want to pause watching at the moment, go and collect some bread and some wine or water to drink, and then restart. Let's worship God. The psalmist wrote, "You desire faithfulness in the inmost being. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow." Let's sing our praise to God in the words of hymn 396, "And Can It Be?"
Thank you.
during Holy Week, we're putting together a collection of symbols of the story of each day during the week. And today's symbol is a towel folded up, or if it's easier, a face cloth. Let's be quiet in prayer. Let us pray. Lord, long ago when people were living in slavery and oppression, you heard their cries and you rescued them. Not because they deserved to be saved, not because they were worthy of salvation, but because of your great love and your faithfulness to your promises. You led them through ways unknown to them, along paths they had not traveled. You were with them in danger and difficulty, and in your generous grace, provided all that they needed. Long ago, a group gathered in the upper room of a city building. Some were full of hope. Some were racked with fear and doubt. Within hours, their world would be shattered. What they had been expecting would not happen. What they had not been expecting did happen. But in the pain and loneliness of that dark night and sorrowful day, your Son saved and rescued them. And not only them, but people of every land and age, that all might know your love, your forgiveness, your call to follow. Come close to us. Accept our praise and worship. Cleanse the unclean things of our hearts. Bring healing and wholeness to our lives. And send us out to serve you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our Bible reading today comes from John's Gospel.
Our reading is from John chapter 13, verses 1 to 17 and verses 31 to 35. It was now the day before the Passover festival. Jesus knew that the hour had come for him to leave this world and go to the Father. He had always loved those in the world who were his own, and he loved them to the very end. Jesus and his disciples were at supper. The devil had already put into the heart of Judas, the son of Simon Iscariot, the thought of betraying Jesus. Jesus knew that the Father had given him complete power. He knew that he had come from God and was going to God. So he rose from the table, took off his outer garment, and tied a towel round his waist. Then he poured some water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel round his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Are you going to wash my feet, Lord?" Jesus answered him, "You do not understand now what I am doing, but you will understand later." Peter declared, "Never at any time will you wash my feet." "If I do not wash your feet," Jesus answered, "you will no longer be my disciple." Simon Peter answered, "Lord, do not wash only my feet then, wash my hands and head too." Jesus said, "Anyone who has had a bath is completely clean, and does not have to wash himself except for his feet. All of you are clean, all except one." Jesus already knew who was going to betray him. That is why he said, "All of you, except one, are clean." After Jesus had washed their feet, he put his outer garment back on and returned to his place at the table. "Do you understand what I have just done to you?" he asked. You call me teacher and Lord, and it is right that you do so, because that is what I am. I, your Lord and teacher, have just washed your feet. You, then, should wash one another's feet. I have set an example for you, so that you will do just what I have done for you. I am telling you the truth. No slave is greater than his master, and no messenger is greater than the one who sent him. Now that you know this truth, how happy you will be if you put it into practice. And verses 31 to 35. After Judas had left, Jesus said, Now the Son of Man's glory is revealed. Now God's glory is revealed through him. And if God's glory is revealed through him, then God will reveal the glory of the Son of Man in himself, and he will do so at once. My children, I shall not be with you very much longer. You will look for me, but I tell you now what I told the Jewish authorities. You cannot go where I am going. And now I give you a new commandment. Love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. If you have love for one another, then everyone will know that you are my disciples. Amen.
When Jewish people gather to celebrate Passover at this time, they usually sing a collection of psalms around the hundred and teens. One of them is Psalm 118, and let's sing part of that now. Hymn number 78, O set ye open unto me. During Holy Week, after our Bible reading, we try to imagine what someone involved in that story might have been thinking. And today we think about what Jesus might have been thinking before the Last Supper. I've always had a good appetite. I suppose it comes from living in the hills, doing heavy manual work, and walking everywhere. We don't eat fancy food, unlike the tales you hear about the palaces in the West End of Jerusalem. But I enjoy soup, stew, vegetables, fruit, beans, fish and bread. Oh, especially newly baked bread. And if Martha ever makes any of those lovely little honey cakes, oh, I could eat the lot. I'm not a foodie who sit and discuss the relative merits of this or that type of onion, nor will I sniff and sample wine to think of suitable adjectives to describe the aroma. On the other hand, I don't just gulp food down, paying no attention to it. I appreciate its taste and flavour, but I also appreciate the kindness of God in providing for us. And I appreciate the hard work of all who harvest and prepare the ingredients for a meal. I don't get much opportunity to eat alone. I'm struggling to remember when I did last eat alone. But I'm glad about that. However good food is, it's always more enjoyable being able to share it with others. I've been to lavish banquets where the host is really only interested in showing off. But I much prefer occasions where it's the company, the people, the chat that are at the center of the meal. And some that I remember best were outdoor picnics or everyone squeezed round the kitchen table. Even if the food is every day and the setting is very plain, it's the welcome and the people who make it a memorable occasion. Here we are gathered for the meal at Passover. In terms of what we eat, it is a special meal, roast lamb. That's something reserved for high days and holidays. But it's special in other ways too. I'm eating with friends and family. It's a day with special customs and practices, packed with symbolism and significance. They aren't just what we've aye done. They have meaning and relevance for today. They remind us that what happened long ago matters for us now. We are part of that scene long ago. And that scene is transported here to our situation and circumstances. Promises made by God to people then about the future still apply. And we await their fulfillment as people did long ago. We gather around this table with different thoughts and ideas, different hopes and memories. But we all come knowing that as we share in this food, we enter into communion with God. We reaffirm what he did for us in the past and what he promises us for the future. I've celebrated a fair number of Passovers over the years, but I'm sure that this one is going to be different. As the lambs were slain for the feast, so I must be slain. Their deaths are a reminder to the Jewish people of what God did to set them free and make them his holy people. I believe that my death will do something very similar. but for everyone. And they will become holy not by keeping rules in the law, but by the Spirit working in their hearts and lives. After today, when we next share bread and wine together, the world will have changed and the kingdom will be coming. Amen. Let's be quiet again in prayer. Let us pray. As we recall your response to the slaves who cried to you for release, we ask you to respond to all who are in need this day. Those who feel the hand of oppression or abuse. Those who look for release from pain or infirmity. Those who long to go home but cannot. Those who are racked by fear or doubt. Those who long to be forgiven and accepted. Those who feel desperately lonely or simply desperate. Those who are very much in our thoughts at this time, and whom now we name in silence before you. All this we pray through Christ our Lord. Amen. We gather on the Thursday of Holy Week. It was on this evening that Jesus gathered with his friends to celebrate the Passover meal, a celebration that we know as the Last Supper, which became the inauguration of the Lord's Supper. Images from the Passover meal were taken up by the church in the way we celebrate the Lord's Supper. And they resonate for us as we hear the story of our Lord's suffering, death, and rising again. To us, Jesus is the Lamb of God, who sacrificed himself for us and enables us to pass over from death to eternal life. As St. Paul said, Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed for us. As at Passover, Jewish people envisage themselves among the slaves in Egypt, sharing their experience, sharing their pain, to share in the joy and excitement of being led to freedom. So we envisage ourselves in the upper room in Jerusalem, where Jesus and his friends gathered. However, we gather here after Easter, after Jesus rising from the dead. Our risen Lord is with us here. He is the head of the feast. It is his table, and he invites us to share with him at it. Let's remind ourselves of Paul's account of the Last Supper. The tradition which I handed on to you came from the Lord himself. That on the night of his arrest, the Lord Jesus took bread. And after giving thanks to God, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in memory of me." In the same way, he took the cup after supper and said, "This cup is the new covenant sealed in my blood. whenever you drink it, do this in memory of me. For every time you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes. As Jesus took bread and wine, we take this bread and wine and set it apart for this holy use and mystery. And as he gave thanks to God, so now let us bring our prayers of thanks and praise to him. Let us pray. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to eat. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to drink. You have chosen us through your grace. You have made us holy by your Spirit. In your love, you have given us this great feast, a celebration of our becoming free, a memorial of our release from sin and death. You have chosen us for your service. You have kept us alive and sustained us. You have brought us to this holy place. Heavenly Father, in the face of your love and goodness, in the face of Jesus' commitment, in the face of his suffering, what can we say? No words are adequate, especially in the light of our own shortcomings. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy upon us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy upon us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us your peace. We rejoice and celebrate that Jesus, who suffered and died, rose from the dead and lives forever, bringing new life, new hope, bringing the assurance that victory lies with goodness, love, and truth, not death, not hatred, not indifference. Send down your Spirit upon us now and upon this bread and wine, so that as we eat together, we may know that the risen Jesus is here with us. We may receive his new life and remain his glad and faithful people until we feast with him in glory. We sum up our prayers in the words of the prayer that he taught us, in whichever version we're used to using. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Jesus took bread, and after giving thanks to God, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in memory of me. In the same way, he took the cup and said, "This cup is the new covenant, sealed by my blood. Whenever you drink it, do this in memory of me." This is the bread of Christ's affliction. Let all who are hungry come and eat. Let all who are in want come and celebrate the feast with us. God bless to us this bread, sign of his body broken on the cross for us, sign that each of us belongs to Christ, sign that we are made one in him, sign that he himself meets us and feeds us here. Let us share in the bread of purity and truth. God bless to us this wine, sign of the Lamb of God, sign of his blood shed that the sins of many might be forgiven. He gives us cause to rejoice, to celebrate in this season and every season. God bless to us the cup of the new covenant. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. The peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. We can't share the sign of the peace with each other because we're all in different places. Maybe if there's somebody else in the house, you can share the peace with them. But one thing we can do, whether you have a laptop or a computer, a phone or a tablet on which you're watching this service, if you put your hand on it and say, "Peace be with you," then you're sharing it with everyone else who is watching this, wherever in the world they are. Let's be quiet again in prayer. Let us pray. Lord, we give you thanks because around this table our hearts have been fed, our thirst has been quenched, our strength is renewed, and we are filled with a new longing for justice and a new spirit of hope. Around this table, we have been made one with all your people in heaven and on earth. We look forward to the day when all the earth is nourished by your bread. We look forward to the day when, with all the company of your people, we eat and drink in the glory of your eternal kingdom. through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our closing hymn is number 376, the paraphrase, "'Twas on that night." Worthy is the Lamb that was slaughtered to receive power and wealth and wisdom and might and honour and glory and blessing. Go out fed by Christ. Go out saved by Christ. go out to watch with Christ. Go out to share the love and good news of Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, rest and remain with you today and every day and forever. Amen.